things they erroneously call God, they are not gods. Our God alone is God. Our God alone
is God.
Somebody shout the Lord alone is God.
The Lord alone is God.
Oh, let the mountains of Kishi hear you. Shout the Lord is God. I say, let the mountains of Kishi hear you. Shout
the Lord
is God. The Lord alone.
Bwana peke.
He's God.
Ndiye Mungu.
Amen.
He said,
Kasema,
you shall also decree a thing and it shall be established. Those who serve the Lord should never fear to decree a thing. It's under 2 years since we stood here and poured oil and dedicated the ground. Under 2 years. 1 year and a half. Here we are.
Now, how about people?
Many of you didn't understand the significance of the scripture that God commanded me to give to the firstborn of this house. It's a symbol of royalty. It's a symbol of dominion. And our mandate here is to raise a people restored to dominion. Meant the city.
Sasa tume imekutana na mji.
Dominion city.
Jiji la mamlaka.
Hallelujah. What a privilege and honor to celebrate our first Sunday service in Dominion City. When there was no pillar standing, only steel from the base, from the foundation. And men and women volunteered to pick a pillar, each part of the pillar. Tell your neighbor you are that pillar today. He said, as we build Dominion City, he is building us.
So change you.
It is a revelation of what is written. Proclaimed so that it will be actualized. You know, as we were worshiping, the Lord gave me a reminder of where, when I was preparing to come to East Africa, I saw a church building. That was in 2014 December. It was like this. In that my vision, I was looking for where to celebrate God's faithfulness. So I met a man average in height. He said to me, I should come and celebrate in that place. And I said to him, I don't know the place. He said, I should just come. So I got into the place, and the song they were singing took me into the spirit. I was seeing different visions and writing them down. After which I joined them to dance. And at the end of it all, that man who brought me in eventually gave me a microphone to talk to the people.
Now,
hatimaye yule mtu ambaye alinipa mwaliko akanipatia kipasa sauti ili kuwazungumzia watu.
And I remember very well when I stood, what I told the people is, this is the fulfillment of prophecy.
Na nakumbuka vema kabisa nilichowaambia watu ni kwamba hii ni kitabu cha nabii.
The man of God did not tell me that I was coming to minister to you on your first Sunday service in this new auditorium here in Dominion City.
Mtumishi wa Mungu hakuniambia ya kwamba nilikuwa nakuja kuhudumia katika Jumapili yenu ya Bwana katika ukumbi wa jiji la utawala.
He just told me that he would like me to join him. There is something very important he wants to do.
Aliniambia ya kwamba angelipenda tu niungane naye kwa sababu kulikuwa na kitu muhimu sana ambaye angependa kufanya.
Few weeks ago he sent me the flyer of the commissioning and he said that is what we are coming to do.
Majuma machache yalipita akanitumia bango ya tangazo ya kile ambacho angelipenda kufanya.
He didn't tell me I was going to be the one to commission his firstborn son in the ministry until I came into this man.
Hakuniambia ya kwamba mimi ndio nitakuwa wa kumzindua mzaliwa wake wa kwanza katika mpaka nilipofika katika nchi ya Kisii.
He didn't tell me that this is going to be the first Sunday service in this place until I'm here now.
Hakuniambia ya kwamba nitahudumu katika Jumapili ya kwanza mpaka niliposikia leo.
And like he said, ordinarily he should have ministered here.
Na jinsi alivyosema kwa njia ya heshima yeye ndiye angelihudumu hapa.
But because prophecy is what is written and revealed.
Lakini kwa sababu unabii ni kilichoandikwa na pia kikafunuliwa.
And because he belongs to the company of prophets, he understands what God is doing.
Na kwa sababu yeye pia ana yeye ni mmoja wapo wale ambao wako katika kundi la manabii anaelewa yale ambayo Mungu anafanya.
I now understand that this is the man who asked me to come. To the place where I will worship.
Niko sasa naelewa ya kwamba huyu ndiye yule Bwana aliyenialika nije katika mahali nitakapo.
When I picked the microphone, I said to the people, this is the fulfillment of prophecy.
Na nilipochukua kipaza sauti na niambia watu ya kwamba huu ni utimilifu wa unabii.
Can I say to you?
Acha niwaambie.
That today,
kwamba leo,
a prophecy over your life and over your destiny has been fulfilled.
Unabii.
You know, I love God.
Wajua napenda Mungu.
Because he doesn't make mistakes.
Kwa sababu hafanyi kosa, hafanyi dosari.
God showed Joseph a vision.
Mungu akamwonyesha Yusufu maono.
1 year passed, no fulfillment.
Mwaka mmoja ukapita, hakuna utimilifu.
5 years passed, no fulfillment.
Miaka mitano ikapita bila utimilifu.
10 years passed, no fulfillment.
Miaka kumi ikapita bila utimilifu.
On the 13th year,
katika mwaka wa 13,
he was in prison.
Alikuwa kwenye jela.
And they beckoned on him.
Na akamuita yeye.
The king has a dream.
Mfalme ako na ndoto.
That has no explanation.
Ambaye aina maelezo.
Can you come and interpret?
Je, waweza kuja na upate kutafsiri?
He interpreted the dream.
Akatafsiri ndoto.
And the interpretation of that dream.
Na tafsiri ya hiyo ndoto.
Was the beginning of the fulfillment of the dream God gave him.
Ilikuwa ni mwanzo wa utimilifu wa ndoto aliyompa Mungu.
Brethren, it is improper and ungodly not to dream.
Wapendwa, ni jambo la dosari na sio cha kiungu kukosa kuota ndoto.
I want you to keep dreaming big dreams.
Nataka uendelee kuota ndoto kubwa kubwa.
If the dream is not big, God is not involved.
Endapo hiyo ndoto sio kubwa, Mungu hajahusishwa.
If it is not a dream that looks impossible to man, God is not involved.
Kama sio ndoto ambayo inaonekana kwa wanadamu haiwezekani, Mungu hajahusishwa.
So Joseph dreamt a difficult dream.
Kwa hivyo Yusufu akaota ndoto ya ajabu na ndoto iliyo ngumu sana.
How will he become a prime minister in a strange land?
Je, atawezaje kuwa waziri mkuu katika nchi nyingine?
How will his brethren bow before him?
Itawezaje kanaje ya kwamba ndugu zake wainame mbele yake?
How will his parents come to where he was?
Itawezekanaje ya kwamba wazazi wake waje mahali alipokuwa kuabudu?
That was a mission impossible.
Hiyo ilikuwa ni tume ambayo haiwezekani.
But with God, no mission is impossible.
Lakini ndani ya Mungu hakuna misheni ama tume ambayo haiwezekani.
The Bible tells us
us in the book of Genesis, I think chapter 42, verse 9. The Bible says, that when Joseph saw his brethren, he recognized them, but they could not recognize him. And then he remembered his dreams. The moment they bowed to him, and I said to you, servant of God, all the demons that said this dream shall not come to pass are now bowing down before you. This is the fulfillment of prophecy. And because it is not a sin to make a decree like this, for me, having received this privilege and opportunity to speak the word of God to you on this first Sunday service, I see a place bigger than this very soon. Father, I give you all the glory.
Papa,
in Nigeria, we call you Okaka.
Kule Nigeria, tunakuita Okaka.
Okaka means you are the greatest, the highest, the best among the rest.
Okaka inamaanisha wewe ni mkuu, mkubwa, yule bora kati ya wengi.
You are higher than the thoughts of men.
Wewe ni mkubwa juu zaidi ya fikra ya wanadamu.
You are in season, on time and out of time.
Wewe ndani ya msimu na ndani ya majira na hata nje ya wakati.
Today we honor you in this dominion city.
Leo tunakupa adama katika jiji hili la utawala.
Deep spiritual encounters on this altar.
Na tunazindua makabiliano ya kiroho katika madhabahu haya.
Lord, be the first worship service where your people celebrate the pillars they raised some months ago.
Bwana, ikiwa ni Jumapili ya kwanza wakati wa kuwako wanasherehekea zile nguzo walipo kuinua miaka moja unusu iliyopita.
To drop the ladder from
heaven.
And open the windows and the doors of
heaven.
Let there be trafficking of angels every day on this ground. Oh God of heaven and earth. Let your fire kiss the earth on this altar. Make this place no other place than the house of God and the gate of heaven.
Amen.
Let there never be a day when there will be no trafficking of angels and a pour of your spirit. The pillars of our God cannot be broken down. You are the pillar that brings down evil caterpillars. Even as we observe these pillars that you have raised in your name today, let every demonic caterpillar in Kisi bow to Dominion City. Let Dominion City take over the evil that has reigned in Kisi City. Let it become the director of the governance of this county. Oh God of heaven, honor your servant and the sons of this ministry. Begin to introduce them to the different counties of this nation. Lord, let it be that prophet
prophecy will continue to be fulfilled in their
lives.
Thank you, eternal rock of ages. We worship you, ancient of days. I am that I am, that I am, that I am. Architect of this building, we give you your place. Raise an altar to you. We ask you to reign and rule. Let your dominion be known in every place from here. Let your servant and all his sons and daughters glorify your name forever. Accept our sacrifices. In Jesus' most anointed name, we pray. The people say loud, amen. Give Jesus a very big hand. Before I will share briefly, I want to teach you a song in case you do not already know it. It's very simple. It says, Ancient of Days, as old as you are. You know it already. As old as you are, you will never change. Ancient of Days, as old as you are, as old as you are, you will never change, you never change. Ancient of Days, as old as you are, as old as you are, you will never change.
Oh, Tigara,
It can only be the Holy Spirit. Yes. Please clap for her. Yes. I'll give you a book. I'll give you one book free.
Amen.
Sing it again. Let us sing it three times and then we'll join her.
Oh, much younger than the Guana go change.
Oh,
kasiku sanduku ya agano
was moved
ilipo ondolewa
from his temporary place
kutoka ile eneo lake la kudumu kwa muda mfupi
to its ever permanent position
mpaka eneo lake la kudumu milele.
Then he danced unto the Lord.
Daudi alimchezea Mungu.
It will be a sin if you come here today, you don't dance, you don't shout.
Itakuwa dhambi uje hapa bila kuchezea Mungu.
If you think it is easy,
unafikiria ni rahisi.
Take a chicken.
Ni rahisi.
To you will let.
Mwambie kuku ukojoa.
You didn't hear me.
Haukusikia.
If you think it is easy,
endapo unafikiria ni rahisi.
Take a chicken to urinate.
Ambia kuku kojoa.
When God does a thing like this in an easy way,
wakati Mungu anapofanya jambo kama hili kwa njia rahisi,
it should be taken and celebrated seriously.
Inatakikana chukuliwe na kusherehekewa. Hakuna mwanadamu yeyote wa kawaida aliyefanikiwa.
Do you understand me?
Je, waelewa?
You have to be abnormal to beat the wickedness of the world and succeed.
Yafaa uwe kichaa kushinda ile uovu wa ulimwengu na kushinda.
Did you hear me? If you and this trumpet as we are normal, you won't get here.
Kama ninyi watu wa tarume
fully praising God. Careful people don't praise God lavishly. Careful people don't praise God lavishly.
Did
you hear me? A woman was delivered from 7 demons.
Mwanamke alikombolewa kutokana na mapepo saba.
And she didn't know how to thank Jesus.
Na hakujua jinsi ya kumshukuru Yesu.
A day came Jesus sat in the home.
Siku ikaja Yesu akiwa amekaa kwenye
nyumba. She carried a bottle of expensive oil.
Akabeba chupa ya mafuta ya dhamana.
And she got to the place.
Na akaenda kwenye eneo.
She wanted to open it.
Alitaka kuifungua.
But she discovered it would waste her time.
Lakini akatambua itapoteza muda wake.
She carried it. Get out of the place first.
For today only, sir, I support you. I also want them to get out. The normal people are not welcome here today.
Listen. Holy Ghost filled people are not normal. number.
As
we are having the morning at 9 a.m. On the day of Pentecost,
they were
Peter said, we are not drunk.
Holy
Ghost has made us different from you.
Yeah.
Are you here?
Yeah.
Today is a day the devil could not stop.
Because
he's a prophet, that's why I can interrupt
him.
The people are renowned all over the world for being gentle as the English people. This year, it is four English clubs meeting in all the European clubs. Four English clubs, one against another, one against another. All over Europe. All the clubs in Europe, it will be only English clubs. Watch them and see how they will be mad and crazy. Those are the people who are known to be gentle all over the world. So today, I don't want normal people. mind to bless you. I'm so excited. I have one and only brother-in-law. He was going through a very difficult time that lasted for many years. But he had an unwavering faith in God. And I believe because of his faith, the Lord decided to honor him. At that time, there was a case of a governor in our state. Who was qualified to contest elections, and they just disqualified him for the sake of envy. He went to court, different stages of court, until he got to the Supreme Court and he won the case. As he won that case, God brought the friend of my brother-in-law into office. As minister of works, they gave them a job worth almost 1 billion. And from the profit, my brother-in-law's life changed. I remember a day he took one old car he had to carry me. I happened to be a friend to his pastor, so I went to their church to minister. Taking me back to the house, he used that old car. And that day it rained heavily. Some parts of the road got flooded. As we were inside of the car, rain was beating us. And all the flood on the road entered the car from the bottom. And I remember that day saying, Lord, please change this car by all means for
me.
So when his friend became minister of works and he got that contract, he bought a very powerful car. When the driver who drove the car from where he bought it from was bringing it to his house, the young man called my brother-in-law and said, we are on our way bringing the car. My brother-in-law said, to where? The man said, to your house, of course. My brother-in-law said, no, you wait somewhere, I'll meet you there. I want us to drive you to pastor's house. That's my house. The man tried to discourage him, but he insisted. I was in the house at about 6:30 a.m. I was still sleeping. But in my sleep, I was having a dream. In that dream, I saw him buy a brand new car. And he brought it to our house. I went into my fridge, I brought out a bottle of wine, I opened them and I began to pour on the car, and I was dancing and rejoicing. It was not up to 10 minutes after that dream, a knock came on my door. That was around 7 a.m. in the morning. And then I said to my son, go and check. He came and said, it is uncle. Uncle came with a car. I said, what do you mean? He says, come and see. It's a brand new car. He said he should call me to come fast. And then I came out, I looked from the window. I saw my brother-in-law and I saw a brand new car. I said, that is my dream. I went to the fridge. I bought bottles of wine. That is why I brought the car here. Because I know you will celebrate my success very well. And then the man who came with him said, no wonder. Do you know why I told you the story? Very soon. Because you rejoice with what God has done here today. People are coming to celebrate your miracles. Did I talk to anybody? Did I talk to any particular individual? I said very soon. What men have said is not possible. God will make it possible for you. In this dominion city. Give Jesus a new clap. God bless you. Sit down. Having said all that, I want to thank Bishop Joseph Otieno.
Nataka kushukuru Askofu Joseph Otieno
for finding me worthy to share with you on this podium. On this exalted global worship center. In case you have not seen this place as a global altar, I want you to begin to recognize that from today. On the 4th of December
2014,
I was powerfully commissioned by my spiritual father to go and reach global altars in different nations. And if I go to churches where I know there are virtues and potentials in the ministers, and I see in the spirit that they are international vessels in a local domain, I play my apostolic and my prophetic function by upgrading their altars to a global altar.
Ninatendeza kazi yangu ya kinabii na ya kimitume kwa kuboresha madhabahu yao kufika kiwango cha kimataifa.
I happen to have been so privileged to raise many of those altars in different nations.
Ilifanyika ya kwamba nilipata tunuku ya kukuza na kuinua madhabahu kama hayo mengi katika mataifa tofauti tofauti,
including America.
Ikiwepo Marekani.
In 2015, I went with my spiritual father for a conference in Florida. On the day the conference was coming to a close, two persons, a couple, walked up to him.
Katika siku ambayo kana hiyo kongamano ilikuwa inaisha, watu wawili akazoa familia walimwendea.
And they said to him, "We are from Casadega."
Kasema kwamba tunatoka Casadega.
Casadega is in central Florida, close to Dillon.
Casadega iko katikati ya Florida, iko karibu na
Dillon.
Iko karibu na Dillon.
They said to him,
"Wakamwambia,
we heard that 25 years ago,
tulisikia kwamba miaka 25 iliyopita,
that you came to Casadega and you went to prophesy on what they call their spiritist altar."
Ya kwamba ulienda na ukatabiri juu ya kile wanachoita madhabahu yao ya kiroho.
At that time there was no single church in Casadega.
Wakati huo hakukuwa na madhabahu ama kanisa hata moja kule Casadega.
In fact, to let you know, you can check it online, Casadega is the spiritual headquarter of the whole world.
Ukweli wa mambo ni kwamba hata ukiangalia kwenye mtandao, Casadega ni eneo ama tukio ya kati ya ulimwengu wote ya masuala ya kiroho.
It's a demonic, little demonic city.
Ni kanchi kadogo ka kipepo.
They have, you know, like their own government. They have their religion,
wakona,
but they are all demonic.
Wakona kitu kama serikali yao, lakini yote ni ya kipepo.
They have what they call the seat of Satan in that Casadega.
Wakona kitu kinachoitwa ile kiti cha shetani katika hiyo mji wa Casadega.
And that is where all the key Hollywood actors go to get their power and inspiration.
Na hapo ndipo nyota wote wa Hollywood wanaenda kupata nguvu zao.
So they came to him and said, "We have a church in Casadega."
Hapo wakakuja kwake wakamwambia, "Tunao kanisa Casadega."
"Oh, we have so many demonic activities going on there."
"Kini tunao kazi nyingi sana za kipepo ambazo zinaendelea pale."
"Can you please," they were talking to my spiritual father, they said, "Can you please come and help us?"
Alikuwa ananena naye babangu wa kiroho akimwambia kwamba tafadhali njoo na utusaidie.
And then he said to them, "I'm busy, I may not be able to come, but I have a son I will send."
Akamwambia kwamba mimi niko na shughuli sita kwa na uwezo wa kuja, lakini ninaye mwana nitakaye mtuma.
We got there and we saw the state of the place.
Kwa hivyo ananionyesha ile eneo.
And I told the man and his wife, "Please drive us into the city of Casadega."
Na nikamwambia yule mwana na mke wake ya kwamba tuendeshe mpaka mji wa Casadega.
We got there, we saw a spring of water where they have their baptisms.
Tukaenda pale tukaona chemichemi ya maji ambapo wanafanya ubatizo wao.
We saw different ghost places where demons visit human beings.
Tukaona maeneo tofauti tofauti ya kipepo ambapo mapepo hutembelea wanadamu.
We saw their restaurants, we saw their hotels and everything.
Tukaona hoteli zao, tukaona nyumba yao na kila kitu.
And we took a prophetic walk.
Na tukafanya kazi ya kinabii, yaani ile msafara ya kinabii.
Now can I pause to say something here, servant of God?
Acha nitulie alafu niseme kitu hapa mtumishi wa Mungu.
You have already taken over this place.
Tayari umepisha nyakua ile eneo.
But you must command all the altars in this place to hear your voice.
Lazima uamuru madhabahu yote katika ile eneo isikie sauti yako.
One of the ways is to take a prophetic walk.
Moja wapo ya njia ni kuchukua ile safari ama mtembeo wa kinabii.
You are a prophet, you know what I'm talking about.
Wewe ni nabii, unajua kile ambacho nanena juu yake.
For myself and our brother who took us, we just went through myself and one other senior colleague of ours, Dr. Chris Maddo.
Kwa hivyo mimi na mmoja wapo ya mkubwa wetu anaitwa Daktari Chris Maddo tukaanza hiyo safari.
We finished, we took a side and we left.
Tukamaliza, tukatabiri na tukatoka.
Some months later we heard that that particular spring dried up.
Miezi michache baadaye tukasikia ya kwamba hiyo
they came on attack to this our brother to kill him, but God delivered
him.
So on the day I went back again in 2017, I discovered why they attacked him. And I began to deal with that. After dealing with it in fasting and prayers, I called him with his wife. He gathered a couple of pastoral friends in the city and they came. And I carried a bottle of oil. And I said to him, from today, you cease to operate on a local altar. You shall not begin to operate on a global altar. I prayed, I went to the place and upgraded it. Before you know it, he became a city pastor. Before you know it, he started going from one stage to another, discipling people. Servant of God, this is an altar. I do not know the state, but I know you are a global minister. Because the Lord gave me a privilege under my mandate to be here on this first Sunday, I lift up my hands to the King of Glory, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the one who was, who is, and who is to come, the Almighty God, our God.
Mungu wetu.
You can come. Mama, come. I lift up my hands to him. And I declare that this is no longer a local altar. It is no longer a county altar.
Only.
It is no longer a national altar. Only. It is not just a continental altar only. It has become a global altar. An altar is a place where heaven kisses the earth. An altar is a place where kneels bow before our God. An altar is a place where destinies are raised. Of deity speaks. By the reason of the upgrade of this altar, the voice of the greatest deity shall begin to speak. Destinies of men shall begin to be raised. From here you shall begin to assess the continents of the world. And the fullness thereof, the Lord and they that dwell therein. He has founded it upon the waters
and
established it upon the soils of
Kishon.
Here in Dominion City, who shall ascend to the hill of the Lord? Who shall receive the blessing from the God of our salvation? It is the servants of God in this place. The sons and daughters in this place. Many who shall come from the nations to worship here. They shall ascend the hill of the Lord. They shall receive the blessings of our God.
Battle.
He is the King of Glory. Akwode.
Mimi Mike Akwode.
I stand under the coverage of the King of Glory.
Nasimama chini ya ufuli wa mfalme utukufu.
And by the oil of my ordination.
Na kupitia mafuta ya utawazwa.
From my spiritual father.
Kutoka kwa babangu wa kiroho.
Mosi Maduba.
Mosi Maduba.
I declare.
Natangaza.
This is a global altar. And it is named after the Lord Jesus Christ. The Lamb of God that was slain before the foundation of this place was laid. I asked him to take his place. May his fire never go out from this place. And may you sons of Dominion City of the Tabernacle, Trumpet Tabernacle, you shall never be ashamed. In Jesus' most powerful name we pray. Now, the altar we have raised today is raised by the empowerment of the elders on the altar of heaven. Man of God, you shall raise 70 ministers like him. From your teachings. They will master their trainings.
Watakuwa ni watu ambao wamejifunza kwa viwango vya juu. Kumakinika katika mafunzo yao.
They will not break their ranks.
Hawatavunja nafasi zao.
They will not be weak.
Hawatakuwa wadhaifu.
They will not be driven by the wind.
Hawatakuwa watu wa kuyumbishwa na upepo.
The threats of the wicked will not terrorize them.
Amen.
Ezekiel chapter 3 verse 8 shall be fulfilled on them. God shall make their faces too strong, too hard for the enemy.
Mungu atafanya uso zao kuwa ngumu sana kwa adui kuwatisha.
He shall make their heads too strong for the devil to conquer.
Atafanya vichwa vyao kuwa ngumu sana kwa adui kushinda.
they will be apostles without fear. They will gather the wealth of the nations. They will raise kings and princes and princesses. They will celebrate righteousness in their generation. They will blow the trumpet for the people to prepare for his second coming. Sickness will not keep them on the bed. Shame will not be their garment. And whatever they open their mouths to say, they will see come to pass. This is the word of the Lord. It's on this premise that this altar is raised. And I bless the Lord for those of you who raise these physical pillars. No caterpillar will pull you down. Bible says, those that put their trust in the Lord, they are like Mount Zion that cannot look be moved.
Wow, ni kama mlima Sayuni ambao hauwezi kutikisika.
In case you are part of this pillar,
endapo wewe ni mmoja wapo ama sehemu ya hizo nguzo,
I say to you by the word of the Lord,
mimi namwambieni kupitia kwa neno la Mungu,
times and seasons will pass, you will never fall.
Misimu na majira yatapita, lakini hautaanguka.
The only thing that will take you out of this world is good old age in the Lord. And in case you have not partook of the building of the pillars, an altar is raised today. It's an opportunity. Father, I see here as a gift for your servants to you.
Kama karama ya mtumishi wako kwako.
Servants of Satan has built altars and houses for him.
Watumishi wa shetani wamemjengea madhabahu na nyumba kwa ajili yake.
It's a privilege to build an edifice like this to our God.
Ni tunuku kujenga jengo rembo na la kupendeza kama hii kwa Mungu wetu.
From my spirit,
toka kwa nafsi yangu,
I bless you today.
Nawabariki leo.
For honoring my God, my Father, and your Father.
Kwa kuheshimu Mungu wangu, baba yangu na baba yako.
Because you have honored him, therefore,
na kwa sababu mmemheshimu kwa hivyo,
I pour oil on this altar.
Na mimina mafuta kwenye haya madhabahu.
This shall be the gate of heaven.
Hii itakuwa ni malango ya mbinguni.
This shall be the gate of heaven.
Hii itakuwa ni malango ya mbinguni.
This shall be the gate of heaven.
Haya itakuwa ni malango ya mbinguni.
It will draw nations.
Italeta mataifa.
It will draw sons and daughters.
Italeta wana na mabinti.
From here the 70 men and women shall be raised. Wise builders. After the order of the vision given to his servant many years ago, every word spoken upon them today shall come to pass. This is the gate of heaven. This is dominion city. The place of blowing the trumpet to the ends of the earth. No devil shall hinder you. As they came to see the wisdom of Solomon, they shall gather from all over the world. They will come with their treasures. They shall come with their resources. The oil of God will never cease in this place. The time will come, this nation will look for the solution. In Jesus' most powerful name, we have raised this altar. Amen.
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 Give me your hand. Amen.
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 Give Jesus a very big clap. If you are clapping, give Jesus a big praise. Before you sit down, man of God,
to make sure
I do my work as a prophet, even in my own city. Even the minister's prayer network, I do it, everybody knows it. I am never ashamed to say what God tells me. From today, listen, sir, please. All of you who are ministers and servants of God, hear me very well.
Anytime
an altar is raised, it will be an error to leave it empty. The strength of an altar is determined by three factors. The deity to whom the altar is raised. Now here, God, who is the Father of spirits, is the one to whom this altar is raised. Number two, it depends on the people, their spiritual capacity, is the capacity of the people who raised the altar. Do you know the good thing that has happened to you today? An international minister is the one speaking today. That's why I have the capacity to do it. Sir, if you did it, even as a global minister, you are still in your local terrain. This is a collection of global altar here. A global altar is not a continental altar. Altars are in their categories and levels. So the people who raise the altar are very important. I told my wife yesterday, I said, the Lord has been urging me to pray that He should sanctify me. Purposely for the work He wants to do in PC, in this ministry. My prayer has been, Lord, sanctify me, prepare me for this work. I didn't tell you that's what I want. When you came to the hotel to pick me,
let me confirm what he's saying. When I picked him from the hotel as we were about to walk out, I held his hand and I said, let us pray. And I said, Heavenly Father, sanctify us by the blood of Jesus for the work you want to do today.
That's what connected the two of us.
Hicho, hicho, kinatuunganisha sisi wawili.
He was not there when God told me.
Hakukuwepo wakati Mungu alinambia.
He was not there when I prayed it.
Hakukuwa pale nalipoiomba.
But when he came into it, he picked it.
Lakini alipoifikia alichukua.
So God prepared me for this work.
Mungu aliniandaa kwa ajili ya kazi hii.
So that therefore this is a global altar.
Kwa hivyo, haya ni madhabahu ya
Mungu.
the altar strong is the strength of the sacrifice.
Na kitu cha tatu ambacho inafanya madhabahu kuwa yenye nguvu ni nguvu ya matoleo ambayo yamefanyika pale.
Before Jesus came,
kabla Yesu kuja,
to slaughter animals just to make atonement.
Wangelimchinja Yesu ili kufanya utakaso.
But when he came,
lakini alipokuja akakaa.
The Bible says a testament is not established without the death of a testator.
Biblia inasema ya kwamba agano haiwezi katimia bila ile ya awali kufa.
So Jesus offered himself to create and raise a new testament.
Kwa hivyo Yesu akajitolea ili kujenga na kuinua agano kipya.
And after that, the Bible says there remained no more sacrifice for sin.
Na kisha baadaye Biblia inasema ya kwamba hakujakuzalia dhabihu nyingine ya dhambi.
That was the highest height of sacrifice to deal with sin.
Hiyo ilikuwa ni kiwango cha juu zaidi ya dhabihu ya kushughulikia dhambi.
And by that, I understand that the strength of a sacrifice determines the strength of the altar.
Na kwa hivyo nikatambua ya kwamba nguvu ya dhabihu pia hutoa mwelekeo wa nguvu ya madhabahu.
Now listen, I've told you the three things that makes up an altar.
Nimewaambia vitu vitatu ambavyo hujenga madhabahu.
There are other minor things like the words spoken and all of that.
Kuna vingine vidogo vidogo kama maneno ambayo yanatamkwa kwenye madhabahu.
Now listen.
Sasa sikiza.
I got to the hotel after we finished and I began to pray.
Nalingia kwenye hoteli baada ya kumaliza nikaanza kuomba.
Yesterday.
Leo nilikuwa.
The Lord indicted me 3 times in 3 minutes.
Eh Bwana akajinitupezea kwangu kwa mara tatu kwa dakika tatu.
Of my prayer. What did he indict me for?
Alikuwa ananisukuma kwa ajili ya nini?
So why did you allow them make that mistake and remain with it?
Na aliuliza kama mbona uliwaruhusu kufanya ile kosa na wasalie na.
Sasa huyo
nasema
and I'm like, Lord, what is the mistake?
Na Mungu dosari kwa nini gani? Kosa ni
to say take.
Did you notice that yesterday we didn't give an offering here?
Okay.
Che ulitambua kwa majana hatukutoa sadaka hapa.
Yeah. Did you notice?
Che ulitambua
why did I take the microphone from him? Because I know God told me the same.
Kwa sababu najua Mungu aliniambia
hiyo watu was a terrible mistake.
Hiyo ilikuwa ni kosa.
After this ordination and the other ones we make some mistakes.
Baada ya yeye na wale wengine watu wanne kutawaza tunafanya kosa kama
hiyo. God have mercy.
Hey, Mungu jorumie.
Lord, please have mercy.
Mungu jorumie.
We couldn't have done this.
To sing and fanya hiki.
Please have mercy. It's not about the money, it's about the reference.
Sio kuhusu pesa lakini heshima na dhamana.
How could we have allowed the enemy to take the glory?
Usingeruhusu aje adui kuchukua utukufu.
You said in your word, if I be a father, where is my honor?
Ulisema ya kwamba endapo mimi ni baba, heshima yangu iko wapi?
Therefore, Lord, have mercy.
Mungu tuhurumie.
Have mercy, Lord.
Tuhurumie, ee Mungu.
Amen.
And I repented for it.
And it took me quite a year.
You remember as we were ministering, I whispered to you, should we take the offering at this level? And then we got carried away.
Nakumbuka ulipokuwa unahudumu nilikunongonezea kwamba je tukusanye sadaka katika kiwango hiki patikisha tukajikuta kwa maana
ile kwamba he reminded me.
Na nilipofika nyumbani nilikumbusha.
So brethren,
kwa hivyo wapendwa,
I will not afford to make you make a second mistake.
Hebu sitamudu kuwawezesha mambo kufanya kosa la pili.
Listen, before you sit down.
Sikiza kabla mkae chini.
I've done the basic thing God wants me to do.
Nafanya vitu vya msingi ambavyo Mungu anataka nifanye.
I'll do one more thing and then I'll drop the microphone.
Nitafanya nyingine moja kisha nitapatia kipaza sauti.
Please, I want to beg you, this is not about money.
Nataka niwasihi, hii sio kuhusu pesa.
Sir, how many servants of his did the Lord ask you to raise?
Hey, mtumishi wa Mungu. Mtumishi wa ngapi ambaye Mungu aliomba uinue?
70.
Yes.
When God wanted to change the history of the kings of Israel.
Wakati Mungu alipotaka kubadilisha historia ya wafalme wa Israeli.
After Saul, David, he came to Solomon.
Baada ya Sauli, Daudi alikuja kwa
Solomon. Something made God to come to Solomon in the dead of the night.
Kile kitu kikafanya Mungu kumjia Sulemani katika usiku wa nabota.
What King Saul didn't do?
Kile ambacho mfalme Sauli akufanya.
What David didn't do?
Kile ambacho Daudi hakufanya.
At the level at which they should have done it.
Katika kiwango ambacho wangelifanya.
Solomon did it.
Sulemani alifanya.
1,000 what? Burnt offering.
Fahali elfu moja. Dhabihu ya fahali elfu moja.
So I want you to take time to teach them about the different offerings we have. So that when you talk about burnt offering, you understand what we mean.
Taka nichukue fursa kuwafundisha dhabihu tofauti ambazo tunazo. Kwa hivyo napenda kuhusu dhabihu ya kuteketeza, unaelewa tunachonena.
It is an offering that is absolutely given to honor God.
Ni dhabihu ambayo inatolewa kwa njia kamilifu ya kumheshimu Mungu.
When God smells the aroma, he's pleased.
Wakati Mungu anaponusa hiyo manukato mazuri ya kuvutia, anapendezwa.
So Solomon gave 1,000.
Kwa hivyo Solomon akatoa fahali 1,000, dhabihu ya fahali 1,000.
Let me tell you the implication. He employs people who slaughter and pay them, because to kill one cow is a big job.
Hata mwambie aliajiri watu wa kuchinja au fahali 1,000, kwa sababu kuchinja fahali moja yani ni kitu cha kugharimu.
1, 2, 3 to 100 into 10 places.
1, 2, 3 to 200 inagharimu.
And in the night God went to his house and knocked at his door.
Na kisha usiku Mungu akaingia katika nyumba yake akabisha mlango wake.
He said to him, open check.
Akampatia ulio wazi.
What do you want?
Unataka nini?
Read your Bible, is there?
Oh yes.
Soma Biblia yako, iko pale.
First Kings 3.
Wafalme wa Kwanza 3.
Go home, read it.
Utaenda nyumbani utasoma.
Solomon asked for wisdom.
Solomoni akauliza hekima.
Listen to this whisper.
Sikia.
The Lord said to him,
Bwana akamwambia,
what you sacrificed,
kile ulichotolea dhabihu,
cannot be left without adding wealth.
Haiwezi ikaacha bila kuongeza mali.
I will add to you wealth that nobody who has been before you and after you will ever be like you.
Nitakuongezea mali ambapo hakuna yeyote bali aliishi kabla yako na nyuma yako ambaye atakuwa kama wewe.
Poverty is a friend to those who are Christians, children of God, who cannot make huge sacrifices.
Umasikini ni ya wale watu wa Mungu ama watoto wa Mungu ambao hawezi wakamudu kutoa dhabihu kubwa.
70 people.
Watu 70.
It's not an easy work.
Yeah.
Sio safari rahisi.
We must raise a sacrifice that is up to 70.
Lazima tuinue dhabihu ambayo inafikia 70.
If you want to do it, do it. If you don't want to do it, I have delivered the message.
Kitaka kuifanya ufanye, kama utaki kuifanya mimi nimekwisha wasilisha ujumbe.
70 people.
Watu 70.
Come.
Watu.
If what you have is 7,000 shillings.
Kama kile ambacho uko nacho ni 7,000.
Or 70,000 shillings.
Ama 70,000.
Whatever is 7.
Kokote ambapo kuna 7.
That can be raised by 70 people.
Ambayo inaweza kuinuliwa na watu 70.
We are going to put it on this altar.
Tunaenda kuiweka katika madhabahu haya.
I am going to put my hope.
Mimi naenda kuweka ya.
I'm not a foolish priest.
Mimi sio kuhani mjinga.
This will be my first fruit in the land of Kisii.
Yafaa hii iwe ni tunda langu la kwanza katika nchi ya Kisii.
I want everybody to sit down if you want to come, please come.
Nataka kila moja akae chini ukitaka kuja.
You must stand close to this altar.
Unakuja unasimama karibu na madhabahu haya.
Give me some song of worship in your dialect.
Me and my house were living 7,000.
good example.
Here, in Father God.
Okay, what does somebody want to do? The latest apostle. When he was speaking yesterday, I'm like, this man has audacity. So the city there will hear his voice.
Amen.
Seven. I like the figure of seven. Great. And you? Seven. And you? And you? And you? Give Jesus a big clap. Those of you sitting down.
What are we doing now, Kachi?
Why?
Mona.
Why and why not?
Mona, Nabona, usijaribu.
If we have up to 10,000, 7,000, we have been up to 10 to 70. And I can pray.
This is the sacrifice of wisdom.
Ecclesiastes chapter 5 tells us we have the sacrifices of fools. They don't know the implication of what they do.
How are you?
So they don't stand like
it.
Make sure you stand by what you are going to say here.
Hakikisha ya kwamba unadumisha na kukuza kile ambacho unaenda kusema hapa.
An altar doesn't die.
Madhabahu haifi.
Did you hear me?
Yes, please.
An altar has a voice even in your absence.
Madhabahu hana sauti hata unapokosa kuwa.
Let me not go into that. There's a book here that talks about altars. You know what I mean?
Kuna kitabu hapa ambacho kinanena kuhusu madhabahu. Meza chuo.
Altars have powers to defend you.
Madhabahu yana nguvu ya kutetea.
And this is the first service here.
Na hii ibada ya kwanza hapa.
So what do you have in your mind you want to do? Seven, seven, one. Pastor, pastor.
I am coming.
Are you saying it because others are saying, oh, that's your mind? Okay, I like that. Don't take anybody's name. Whatever you say here, write it, bring it on. If you don't have it, okay?
On this first Sunday worship
at Dominion City, I come representing myself and everything around me. I bring this sacrifice to you. And I ask you, let the first fruit of the blessings of the spiritual release of this man.
Of the spiritual release of this man.
Be put in my hands.
Be put in my hands.
And let the covenant I enter with you today.
Let the covenant I enter with you today.
Be renewed by your spirit.
Be renewed by your spirit.
That every good and every perfect gift.
That every good and every perfect gift.
That comes from you.
That comes from you.
Will touch my hands.
Will touch my hands.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Put your hands together for the Lord. Right up there.
To make sure I go.
Climb up. You and Mama. You two come. Can all of you come close? Come closer to us. Come. Any of you open your hands? Okay, now. Okay, your wife. Why is she not here? Okay, she went back. Okay, come here now. Come quickly. Run like a runner, like East African long marathoners. Open your hands. From this altar, I stand as a priest to give me the opportunity. I receive from heaven every fruit
kila tunda
that God has ordained for this altar. At the head of the church in human body, I put them in your hands.
Hey,
man of God, go and give to your people. That's how it is done. Put
it
in their hands. Whatever your faith receives is what you have. Receive the blessings of the sacrifice. But you say, if you are willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. Let me give it to you today. Wherever you are right now,
the count of seven, let every yoke around your life receive the power of God to bow. Is somebody ready? The Lord is coming upon somebody. There are 25 of you. This anointing will lift you from the low level. It will bring you to a place of power.
pesa na apostle.
Alipoenda pale Bwana akaniambia kwamba huyu mtoto hapa ni mtume.
But the devil has been stealing the babies from this woman's womb and has been ravishing their lives.
Bwana shetani amekuwa akiba watoto kutoka tumbo huyu mwanadada na amekuwa akiwapokonya hatima yao.
That as this one is brought to the altar.
Lakini huyu ameletwa kwenye madhabahu.
Good. That as this one is brought to the altar, that demonic yoke that takes the children and uses them,
yeah,
it shall be broken.
Okay.
Therefore, that yoke is broken. That demonic altar is set on fire. I redeem your children, woman.
Under my hello,
that demon that bound you,
we are people and find
out Peter. Arise your children.
Arise,
I command you today.
Now,
at the reason of this dominion altar, now you can go. I command you. The name of the Lord God of hosts. Separated from your altar today, I bring her before the altar of God. And I challenge you. I see you are from the water. And you operate in the manner of witchcraft. Generation for you. Somebody say amen.
Amen.